One of my favorite dishes is fried chicken, but I'm gonna put my own spin on it because I'm gonna make it an oven fried chicken. By far, much easier and simpler to do, and it's also healthier for you. Once it's seasoned with my herb mix and coat it with a little flour and put in the oven, 45 minutes later, you have some really good fried chicken. So let's get started here. I have a 2.5 pound organic chicken. It's a whole chicken, and I want to show you a very easy way just to cut the chicken up. Of course, you can buy it in pieces at the market, but you can save a little bit of money if you cut up your chicken rather than get it pre-cut. So what we have here is, of course, the legs and the wings. The easiest way to cut it naturally is to have the wings towards the back or towards you, and kind of hold on to the legs, make two slots, spin it around. Now what you can do is with a knife, just take and break out the leg and thigh. And now you have one piece. If you wanted to leave it as one, you could leave it together, or you can just make a cut and separate the two of them. Now you'll notice with the chicken, there's kind of a line here. There's a little line of fat, and it actually separates the joint bone. So follow that right through, and then you can separate the drumstick from the thigh. And of course, you can do the same thing with the other one. And the thing with any type of butchering or cutting that you're doing is you want to let the knife do the work. When you are butchering, you only want to use the tip of the knife. Just let the knife do the work. You shouldn't be using the back end, the heel end of it. A bony knife, you're using the tip of it. So you almost let gravity do its work. Take and pop it again, away from the back. Again, you have the same line right here. Of course, you cut it back. The wings, again, just let gravity work for you. Separate it from the breast. Pull it up, let gravity work for you. Separate it from the breast. Take the back. Now, sometimes you can leave the back as part of the thigh, but I actually like eating the backs, so I always cut them this way and leave the back whole, or if I'm making stock, I'll even use the back for the stock. Next thing I'll do is just separate the fore part of the back away from the breasts. Now you could leave the breast whole if you wanted to just roast it and have a nice roasted piece of breast, or you just take and you kind of cut out a little bit of the cartilage by the end of the back. So sometimes the difference of being able to cut up your own chicken versus buying it already cut up sometimes can be, you know, a couple dollars a pound. Now we'll season the chicken with a mixture of the dried herbs, which is basil, oregano, a little thyme, all ground together, a small amount of paprika, a little sweet paprika on the chicken, a small amount of powdered garlic, and then just a pinch of nutmeg. Just rub in all the spices. Okay, once your hands have been washed, we want to take and put a little fresh lemon juice on the chicken. It really adds a nice flavor. And what you want to do with the lemon is, before you cut it open, you just want to squeeze it or rub it, and you're loosening all the juices inside the lemon. And then see how they just run right out by loosening it up. So now for the chicken. I found the best way, you could just toss in the flour and the chicken. What begins to happen then is sometimes it coats a little too heavy in one spot, and one of the easiest ways I found is just to take a small amount of flour and put it in a bag. You can use a plastic Ziploc type bag, or you could use a paper bag. A little fresh sea salt on the chicken. And then you're ready to go. Put like a piece or two at a time in the bag. close your bag up well. My mom, when she used to make fried chicken, she'd even use a brown bag, a brown paper bag to coat it. But my mom used the old traditional way. She fried her chicken. But sometimes, like I said, frying it can be a little bit messier and maybe sometimes not as good for you. So you just keep repeating. And then once the chicken starts to get a little light brown, which would take maybe 20, 25 minutes, you want to cut the temperature down to like 350 degrees until the chicken is fully cooked. And what's nice is you might think, well, where's the wonderful amount of fat that sometimes goes along with fried chicken? Actually, the natural fat that's in chicken and underneath the skin is actually what begins to fry it while it's in the oven. So I put it in a very hot oven, 425 degrees, for about 15 to 20 minutes. After that, the aroma is going to tell you, hey, it's time to check me. Lower it to 350 degrees for about 30 minutes. So this is a great alternative than the traditional fried chicken. Of course, it's much better for you, but it's just as crispy. You can see how well browned the chicken has all become. All the different spices and the seasonings. And there's nothing better than a steamy bit of fried chicken, even if it's oven fried chicken. And it's one of those things, when it comes out of the oven, you certainly are not gonna wanna wait. I know I don't. That was so good. Mm-mm-mm.